This video is about using high voltage or high pot testing to verify the insulation of your cables and harnesses. We will explain what high pot is, how it finds problems that low voltage testing cannot, and we'll show specific applications where high pot testing can improve quality in cables and harnesses. To help portray the concepts, we'll use a diagram of a simple cable assembly. Points in connectors are connected via conductors or wires, which are separated by insulation. There are three basic errors that occur in cable assemblies: opens, shorts, and miswires. While low voltage cable testers can find any of these errors, they can only catch shorts if the wires actually come in contact, or in other words, copper touching copper. But in many instances, you may have nicked insulation, stray wires, braided shielding, or contaminants such as solder flux that can cause wires to be very close, but not actually dead shorted to each other. In these cases, high voltage tests can find shorts or near shorts that low voltage tests cannot. To help explain, we'll use a garden hose or water pipe analogy. There are similar concepts between a water hose and an electrical wire. In a garden hose or water pipe, you have water pressure, measured in pounds per square inch. This is similar to voltage in a cable, measured in volts. You have water flow, measured in gallons per minute. This is similar to current flow in a cable, measured in amps. And you have resistance, based on the diameter of the hose, just like resistance based on the gauge of a wire. Now imagine that we have a water hose with a small nick or pinhole in it, just like we might have a cable with a small nick or a pinhole in the insulation. If we only have a little bit of water pressure in the hose, say 5 psi, then we only get a small dribble of water through the pinhole. But if we turn up the water pressure, say to 500 psi, then we get an obvious stream of water leaking out. One key difference to note between water and electricity: while water will leak out of a hole into air, electricity won't. It requires a conductive path. In other words, you need two wires, exposed or a wire and some other metal like the cable shield. But similar to increased water pressure in our hose, increased voltage can cause leaking or arcing between exposed wires in our cables, helping us catch errors that we would otherwise miss. A few important points to understand about high pot testing on Cirris testers. A Cirris tester will not damage your cables. Although high voltage is being applied, the available current is limited to avoid damaging the cable. If programmed properly, it will not damage components in your cable. Cirris testers link components together during the high pot test, so that no voltage drop ever occurs across sensitive components. Testers with hazardous currents require a safety interlock to avoid harm to the operator. These interlocks can be used even on testers with non-hazardous and non-harmful currents, such as our 1100H+, Touch1, and CH+. To summarize, low voltage tests are fine for catching dead shorts when exposed conductors are actually touching. But in cases where exposed wires are very close but not actually touching, high pot testing is like having a bigger magnifying glass to look for these kind of insulation problems. If you wonder what type of testing is best for you, contact one of our technical sales consultants today. We can analyze your cables and recommend the best solution.